Quantum computing offers profound implications for both neurological and cosmological theories, particularly in exploring the concept of non-computability. In this context, quantum computing provides a framework for understanding consciousness and the fundamental workings of the universe. This hypothesis is based on quantum computing's use of fundamental quantum mechanical principles, such as superposition, quantum entanglement, and wave function collapse. In classical computing, information is encoded in binary bits that exist strictly as zeros or ones. However, quantum computing exploits the superposition principle, where qubits can exist simultaneously as zeros, ones, or any quantum superposition of these states. This extension allows quantum computers to process vast amounts of information in parallel, providing a computational advantage over classical systems. In quantum mechanics, quantum particles exhibit both particle-like and wave-like properties. This duality is embodied in the behavior of photons and electrons, which can behave as either discrete particles or continuous waves, depending on the experimental context. While the continuous nature of energy as a wave form may seem intuitive, the particulate aspect of energy gained significant support in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Three critical phenomena, cathode rays, the photoelectric effect, and blackbody radiation, were eventually explained through the quantization of energy. Experiments with cathode rays revealed electrons as negatively charged particles that carry electricity. The photoelectric effect, in which light releases electrons from matter, led Einstein to propose the quantized theory of light in 1905. Using Planck's law, Einstein explained the photoelectric effect by quantizing light and determined Planck's constant, H, as the constant of proportionality between the energy of the light packets, Tvst, and the frequency of the emitted energy, F. Planck's law also correctly described blackbody radiation, resolving the ultraviolet catastrophe predicted by classical physics. The double-slit experiment conducted by Thomas Young in the early 19th century remains a fundamental demonstration of wave-particle duality. When monochromatic light passes through two slits, it produces an interference pattern on the screen that suggests wave-like behavior. Particles, such as electrons, even when passing through individual slits, produce an interference pattern that reinforces the notion that particles have wave-like properties. The peculiar behavior observed in the double-slit experiment, in which the brightest part of the light appears just behind the blocked area between the slits, highlights the interference of waves. This phenomenon is a direct result of constructive and destructive interference patterns created by the crests and troughs of light waves, and these either reinforce or cancel each other out. Even when the light is so weak that only one photon passes through the slits at a time, the interference pattern persists. This experimental observation also shows us that the wave nature is an intrinsic property of individual photons, not just an epiphenomenon of many photons. Each photon seems to interact with itself. This is a confusing concept that deepens when measurements are made. Once a measurement determines which slit a photon went through, the interference pattern disappears, indicating that the act of measuring changes the behavior of the system. This reveals a fundamental aspect of quantum mechanics. Observers cannot be completely objective because their measurements affect the reality they observe. The Schrödinger equation is the cornerstone of quantum mechanics, which describes how the quantum state of a physical system evolves. This equation supports the probabilistic nature of quantum mechanics and determines the probability of finding a particle in a particular state. Quantum superposition is a fundamental concept that arises from solutions of the Schrödinger wave equation. These solutions, called wave functions, BAX, describe the various possible states of a quantum system. These states correspond, for example, to a particle's spin being up or down. The Schrödinger equation has a unique property, the linearity of its solutions. This means that the sum of any number of solutions, wave functions, that make up the system is also a valid solution. As a result, until a measurement is made to determine the true state of a system, the system exists in a superposition of all possible states. Therefore, until observed, Schrödinger's cat is simultaneously dead and alive, and a particle's spin is both up and down. During the measurement, the superposition collapses into one of the possible states, transforming a quantum state into a classical state. This process, often called wave function collapse, determines whether the cat is dead or alive, and whether the particle's spin is up or down. The Heisenberg Uncertainty Principle states that certain pairs of physical properties, such as position and momentum, cannot be measured simultaneously with arbitrary precision. This inherent limitation emphasizes the probabilistic and uncertain nature of quantum systems and contrasts sharply with the deterministic view of classical mechanics. In particular, the more precisely we determine the position of a particle, the less precisely we can know its momentum, and vice versa. When we observe or measure a quantum system, we always disturb its superposition state. This disturbance occurs because the act of measurement itself transfers energy to the system. To measure the position of a particle with high precision, short wavelength and therefore high momentum light must be used. This high momentum light transfers a significant amount of energy to the particle, thereby greatly changing its momentum. Conversely, to measure momentum accurately, low momentum, long wavelength light is needed, which lacks the spatial resolution required for precise position measurements. The inherent uncertainty in determining the state in which a system will collapse is one of the cornerstones of quantum mechanics. Max Born's interpretation of the Schrödinger equation introduced the concept of probability amplitude. The square of the absolute value of the amplitude of the wave function provides the probability that the system will collapse to the state associated with that wave function. This probabilistic structure dictates the transition from quantum to classical states, a concept that troubled many early physicists, including Einstein and Schrödinger, who sought a fundamental determinism beyond mere probability. Whether the superposition reflects a real physical reality or merely our knowledge of the system remains a matter of debate. The Schrödinger wave equation, which describes the probabilistic behavior of particles, inherently contains this uncertainty. Reflecting the fundamental probabilistic nature of quantum systems, it predicts the probability distribution of a particle's location rather than its exact location. Albert Einstein resisted the probabilistic interpretation of quantum mechanics. He believed that beneath the apparent randomness and uncertainty of quantum mechanics, there is a fundamental reality in which particles simultaneously have definite positions and momenta, even if we cannot measure them. Niels Bohr and proponents of the Copenhagen interpretation challenged this view by arguing that quantum mechanics does not merely reflect our lack of knowledge, but also describes an inherent uncertainty in nature. According to this interpretation, particles do not have definite properties independent of measurement. The reality of a particle's position and momentum only becomes apparent upon observation. The debate between Einstein's search for fundamental determinism and Bohr's acceptance of the inherent uncertainty of quantum mechanics continues to inspire philosophical and scientific inquiry, leading to deeper investigations into the nature of the quantum world. Entanglement is a phenomenon in which particles are intertwined, and the state of one instantly affects the state of the other, regardless of the distance between them. This non-local property of quantum entanglement offers significant potential for quantum computing, allowing entangled qubits to perform coordinated operations with unprecedented speed and efficiency. It suggests that if quantum mechanics is complete, two particles that are entangled and separated by large distances can instantly affect each other's state, seemingly violating the principle of local causality. This paradox has been investigated experimentally and provides significant support for non-local interpretations of quantum mechanics. In 1935, Einstein, Podolsky, and Rosen proposed the EPR paradox, a thought experiment that aimed to demonstrate the incompleteness of quantum mechanics. The EPR paradox questions the completeness of quantum mechanics, questioning the nature of reality and locality. They argued that quantum theory could not fully describe the simultaneous measurement of unchanging variables, such as position and momentum. The EPR paper aimed to show that there must be hidden variables that are not accounted for in quantum mechanics. The EPR thought experiment involves a particle that is initially in a spin-zero state, turning into two entangled particles with opposite spin states that are moving away from each other. When the spin of one particle is measured using a Stern-Gerlach apparatus, the spin state of the other particle becomes known instantly due to their correlated behavior. The EPR experiment is based on a concept called local hidden variables, which holds that the result of a measurement of one particle cannot instantly affect the other, and that the spin states of the particles must be predetermined. In 1964, John Bell formulated a theorem to test the validity of local hidden variables, employing what is now known as the Bell inequality. Bell showed that if local hidden variables are responsible for quantum entanglement, the results of certain experiments must obey certain probabilistic constraints. Bell's theorem provides a critical test for distinguishing between local hidden variable theories and quantum mechanics. The theorem shows that no local hidden variable theory can reproduce all the predictions of quantum mechanics. Bell derived an inequality that local theories must satisfy. However, later experiments, most notably those by Alain Aspect in the 1980s, violated Bell's inequality. These results confirmed that local hidden variables cannot explain the observed quantum correlations, thus supporting the non-local nature of quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics predicts correlations that can violate this inequality, which has been experimentally verified. The instantaneous correlation paradox arises from the question, how do entangled particles instantaneously know each other's states, even when separated by large distances? This phenomenon, often referred to by Einstein as spooky action at a distance, challenges classical notions of locality and causality. David Bohm has proposed an alternative interpretation that involves hidden, non-local variables. According to Bohm, observed particles are manifestations of a deeper underlying reality that he calls intrinsic order. In this framework, the revealed order, our observable universe, is merely a superficial expression of the implicit order. Bohm introduced the concept of quantum potential, a fundamental field that provides a holistic view of the universe and instantly affects particles regardless of distance. This quantum potential allows particles to interact with each other and instantly transmit information, like a radar system connecting each particle to the rest of the universe. This potential also allows for non-local interactions and proposes a universe in which time and space are secondary structures emerging from a deeper, more fundamental reality. David Bohm's theory suggests that our observable reality, the order it contains, is a manifestation of a deeper, underlying reality, the order it contains. In the order it contains, everything is fundamentally interconnected, and in the order it describes, the separateness we perceive is an illusion. Bohm's theory challenges the classical view of an independent, objective reality. It implies that the universe is fundamentally interconnected, and that what we perceive as separate entities are merely different aspects of a unified whole. Recent research explores the concept of temporal non-locality, where entanglement extends beyond spatial dimensions to include time. This suggests that particles can be entangled not only in space but also in different times. Time-symmetric interpretations of quantum mechanics suggest that the laws of physics are invariant under time reversal. This could mean that future events can affect the past, leading to a retroactive causal explanation of entanglement. In this context, an integral theory of time that includes the concepts of temporal reversal and timelessness could provide new insights into the EPR paradox. Similar to Bohm's implied scheme, the concept of timelessness could serve as a global hidden variable that binds entangled particles together. Thanks for listening, and take care.